grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Almighty God, whose Son was crucified yet entered into glory, may we, walking in the way of the cross, find it is for us the way of life. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
A reading from the Gospel according to John. 6 days before the Passover, Jesus came to Bethany, the home of Lazarus, whom he had raised from the dead. There they gave a dinner for him. Martha served, and Lazarus was one of those at the table with him. Mary took a pound of costly perfume made of pure nard, anointed Jesus' feet, and wiped them with her hair. The house was filled with the fragrance of the perfume. But Judas Iscariot, one of his disciples, the one who was about to betray him, said, "Why was this perfume not sold for 300 denarii and the money given to the poor?" He said this not because he cared about the poor, but because he was a thief. He kept the common purse and used to steal what was put into it. Jesus said, "Leave her alone. She bought it so that she might keep it for the day of my burial. You always have the poor with you, but you do not always have me." When the great crowd of the Jews learned that he was there, they came not only because of Jesus, but also to see Lazarus, whom he had raised from the dead. So the chief priests planned to put Lazarus to death as well, since it was on account of him that many of the Jews were deserting and were believing in Jesus. Hear what the Spirit is saying to the church.
Thanks be to God.
Mary took a pound of costly ointment of pure nard and anointed the feet of Jesus and wiped his feet with her hair, and the house was filled with the fragrance of the ointment. The Lord Jesus understood what this anointing meant. Mary had performed the sacrament of his burial. Anointing was performed for other very different reasons, too. Aaron, the brother of Moses, was made a priest when a jar of oil was poured over his head. So much oil that, as Psalm 133 puts it, the ointment ran down upon Aaron's beard and even soaked the collar of his robe. And David was made king over Israel when Samuel poured a cruet of oil over the crown of his head. These anointings were a sacrament not of entombment, but of enthronement. The pouring of oil upon the head symbolized priestly or kingly power, and more than that, actually conferred the power thus signified. People go head first into power. They go feet first into the grave. Jesus was anointed on his feet, not on his head. So his anointing at Bethany signified the deprivation of all power, the destruction of all authority, that is death and the grave. Aaron's priesthood may have endured in his progeny, but Aaron himself had no more power to bless or sacrifice when his feet were carried over the verge of his tomb. David had his heirs on the throne of Judah, but he himself passed under the sovereign power of death. And yet, when Mary anointed the feet of Jesus and made a sacrament of his burial, she symbolized more than just his death. The anointing at Bethany signified the great paradox. Jesus, even in his powerlessness, was to exercise the greatest power of all. One of the prophecies of Christ said that God would put David's enemies under his feet. When Mary anointed the feet of Jesus, she foreshadowed the vanquishing of the last enemy. She did this on Monday, the second day of the week. On Sunday, the eighth day, Jesus, the Son of David, will rest his foot on the neck of conquered death. And may the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God, and of his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be amongst you and remain with you always. Amen. Amen. Mm-hmm.